Hey, we're out in the Oregon Badlands wilderness today to talk about native plants. Not just what they are, but how to identify them. So if you see a plant and you want to know what it is, you're going to learn that skill today.
My name is Ann White, and I am a sagebrush step monitoring tech with Onda's Sage Grouse Habitat Monitoring Program. I've spent the last 3 seasons out in Laos Canyon, walking around and looking at all the plant life out there.
You don't need much in the field to identify forbs. All you need is a backpack, a guidebook, your phone to take pictures, and a hand lens to look at small flowers.
We found a wildflower. Yes. It's very beautiful. I bet Anne already knows what it is, but I do not, so she's going to walk me through the process of narrowing it down. And how many wildflowers are there in Oregon?
Well, there are close to 2,000 species in Oregon.
The first thing I'm noticing is that it's white. Does mm-hmm. that help?
That does, yes.
Okay.
Color is a great way to start with a flower.
Then what do I want to look for?
There's a lot of different components going on here. So the next thing that I would look at is how many petals there are and what's the arrangement of the petals. So this is a bunch of flowers on one. So this, we're gonna look at both 5 petals in the book and also composite. Composite is when there's a bunch of different petals on there. Then once you get into the leaves, whether they're opposite, alternate, and then potentially even the basal leaves, which are right down here around the bottom, that can really help you narrow it down and find the species that it is. I like to use Turner's book for identifying wildflowers. It organizes them by color and then by number of petals.
All right, I think Anne has her verdict.
That's right, this is Chinactis douglasii, also known commonly as Dusty Maidens. If we look in the book at the description, it says it has perennial persistent basal rosette, which means that these leaves around the base of the flower are here all the time. And then looking at the flower, it says flower heads single to many, each on separate stalks. Each of these little stalks is a big cluster of flowers. And that's how we know this is Dusty Maidens.
We've found another cool one. It's pink. I can
yes.
tell you that much. And I think it has, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 petals. You don't see much in the way of leaves, so is that enough to go on?
It's enough to start. The other thing you'll want to look at is what's the structure of the petals. Because this has this bottom petal here that's noticeably smaller than the others, this is going to be considered irregular, which will really help narrow down the species that it could be. And one way that you can really narrow down and identify the species that you're looking at is looking at the habitat type.
Okay. I'm in the section 5 irregular petals forming a tube. Definitely. Okay. It's obviously the dwarf monkey flower.
That's right.
The size. It's very small.
Yes.
Okay. 1/2 inch to 4 inches. Uncommon. All summer. Annual. Grows on sandy or bare soils at mid to high elevations.
Perfect. Well, that is it then.